What does this have to do with images? Well, let me tell you. I'm going to introduce this using the notion of face images, because frankly, it was this eigenvector approach to doing face recognition that really, I think, caught people's attention. Think of an image now not as a two-dimensional thing, but as just one great big long vector, okay? So it's just got a whole bunch of values in it. So for example, suppose I had a vector that was 100 by 100 long. How many pixels is that, Megan? 100 by 100?
10,000.
10,000, you got it right. 100 times 100 is 10,000. So that's just a 10,000 long vector. If I don't worry about the fact that their pixels located in a particular position, which by the way is going to be an interesting problem later, if I just think of them as values, that's a 10,000 dimensional space, right? There's 10,000 dimensions. Each dimension has a value. What's the value? It's the value of the pixel that corresponds to that location. This location is another pixel. Its value 18, fine. That's its value here. So the idea is that an image is just a 10,000 dimensional vector. Question, how many of those 10,000 dimensional vectors, how many 100 by 100 pictures, are actually pictures of faces? I mean, just of a face. Answer, not a whole lot, okay? In fact, most values, right, if I just randomly put numbers in that vector, right, I get out, you know, random pixels everywhere, right? The idea is that faces are a very special set of vectors. They're not all possible vectors, and they're not distributed everywhere in this image space. They are on some particular, what's referred to as a subspace, sometimes a manifold, okay? They're in a subspace of all images, okay? By the way, we sometimes call that subspace face space. What's face space? It's the subspace in the space of images that are the pictures of faces. All right, so here's what we want to do. And this is color-coded, so we want to build a low-dimensional, because we're going to try to get a nice dimensionality reduction going on here, linear, we'll talk about the use of linearity to be able to just do dot products to get our coefficient, subspace, so it's going to be some reduced space, that explains the most of the variations seen in face images. And that's just drawn out here. This looks just like what we had before, where we had blue dots and orange dots. Now I'm telling you, well, actually, even though this is drawn as just a two-dimensional space, because I can only draw two, it's a 10,000-dimensional space, 10,000 pixels. You're like, okay, fine, 10,000 pixels. And the idea is, let me find the direction or directions in that image along which most of the face images lie. And that's what it shows here, that this cyan color is sort of ideas that the face images are there. And then we've got all these other images that are not images of faces. They're cats. Well, they're all sorts of things, okay? Whatever the internet has pictures of and all other possible things, all right?